Let's talk about evaluating trig functions. So now that we know how the trig functions are defined, let's see how we can make use of those definitions. So for example, let's find cosecant of negative 13 pi over 4. So the first thing I notice is that the angle is negative, right? So that means we are rotating in the clockwise direction. So I'm going to rotate 13 pi over 4, but in the clockwise direction. Now, we're assuming all angles are measured in radians unless otherwise indicated, okay? So this is negative 13 pi over 4 radians. Okay, so rotating in the clockwise direction. Now, the question is, we have to rotate 13 pi over 4 radians, right? That's kind of a hard angle to think about, right? It doesn't come naturally. So what we're going to do is we are going to think in terms of integer multiples of pi. Like, for example, I'm thinking about the angles like negative pi and 0 and pi and 2 pi and 3 pi, for example, and 4 pi, right? These are what we mean by integer multiples of pi. And so what I want to do is ask myself, how close is this angle to an integer multiple of pi? Now, for the moment, I'm going to disregard the negative. I'm just going to focus on the 13 pi over 4. So let me write that down, 13 pi over 4. Now, remember, we're aiming for some integer multiple of pi. So when I look at this, I say to myself, well, 4 doesn't go into 13, but 4 certainly goes into 12, right? So if I think about 12 pi over 4, 13 pi over 4 is very close to that. Now, 12 pi over 4, rather, is 3 pi, okay? Now, 13 pi over 4, of course, is not equal to 12 pi over 4. I'd have to take this and I'd have to add pi over 4 to it, right? So my point is that 12 pi over 4 plus pi over 4 is 13 pi over 4. And this right here, that 12 pi over 4, that's easy to work with. That's 3 pi. So let's take all those ideas together. We are rotating in the clockwise direction, and we're going to rotate 3 pi plus pi over 4. Okay, so here we go. 3 pi, first of all, well, this far is 2 pi, then keep rotating, that's 3 pi, and then another pi over 4. So pi over 4 is 45 degrees. So we're going to end up, let's go ahead and draw this in, let's draw the terminal side of our angle, 45 degrees. So let's go right about there, okay? So our angle is negative 13 pi over 4. So we rotate all the way around once, and then half, and then another pi over 4. So this point up here is where the terminal side of the angle meets the circle. Now, when you think about evaluating trig functions, right, what you need are x, y, and r. And you're free to choose any r you want, as we discussed. So I'm going to choose an r of length 1. Okay. So when I do that, remember, I'm talking about the unit circle. And what I'm going to now do is I'm going to form a triangle here so I can think about my reference angle. So I'm going to drop a perpendicular to the x-axis. And this is always what you do. Where the terminal side of your angle meets your circle, you always want to draw a perpendicular to the x-axis so that you form a right triangle with an acute angle. Now remember, we said this angle was 45 degrees, right? So my reference angle is 45 degrees. Now, if this is 90, that makes this angle 45 degrees as well. So I have a 45, 45, 90 triangle. And as we discussed, when you have that with a 45, 45, 90 triangle with a hypotenuse of length 1, that makes this length root 2 over 2 and this length root 2 over 2 as well. Now, that means the x-coordinate, well, it's not going to be positive root 2 over 2. It's going to be negative, right? Because the x-coordinate is negative in quadrants 2 and 3. So the x-coordinate is going to be negative root 2 over 2. And the y-coordinate, well, the length is root 2 over 2, but the coordinate itself is positive, right? Because the y-coordinate is positive in quadrants 1 and 2. So the y-coordinate is positive root 2 over 2. Okay, so we have the x, we have the y, and we have the r. Now, once you have those three quantities, you can find any Trig function of any angle, or I should say, any trig function of the angle you're talking about. So in this case, I want cosecant of negative 13 pi over 4. Let's write that down. Cosecant of of this angle, right? Negative 13 pi over 4. And by definition, that's that's r over y. So r is 1, and y is root 2 over 2. So it's going to be 1 divided by root 2 over 2, right? R over y. Now, of course, when you have 1 divided by a fraction, right, it's 1 times the reciprocal of this, which is just the reciprocal of that. So it's going to be 2 over the square root of 2. And that leaves us with just, if I rationalize the denominator and multiply top and bottom by root 2, that's going to be 2 root 2. And root 2 times root 2 is just 2. And now the 2's cancel. So I just get root 2. So cosecant of negative 13 pi over 4, that's going to be simply root 2. Okay, so what we want to do, let's just recap what we talked about. You plot your angle, but it's really important to think about how your angle is related to an integer multiple of pi, because that makes locating it a lot easier. And then once you locate your angle, you figure out your reference angle, draw on the triangle, and then find the x coordinate, the y coordinate, and the r, and simply take the ratio that you're asked to find based upon the trig function you're working with. Okay, let's try another one like that. Okay, this one's slightly different. So what it says is that we're given a point, negative 2, 3, on the terminal side of an angle in standard position. Okay, so the point on the terminal side, negative 2, 3. Find the values of all 6 trig functions of that angle. Well, let's first locate that point, negative 2, 3. So x is negative 2 and y is positive 3. So maybe the point is, let's say, right about maybe here. X is negative 2 and y is 3. Okay, let's draw in the terminal side. Okay, maybe like that. So up here is the point, negative 2, 3. Now, do you see how this problem is a little different than the previous one? In the previous one, of course, you knew what the angle was, and then you found your r, or you decided what your r was, and then you found your x and your y. This is different. You don't know what the angle is, but you do know what x and y are. Now, of course, x, y, and r are all related by the Pythagorean theorem. So if you draw on your right triangle here, like so, right, dropping a perpendicular, this would be your r. Now, the r is not 1. How do I know that? Well, because x is negative 2 and y is 3, and x, y, and r are always related through this relationship. X squared plus y squared equals r squared. Okay, that's always true for x, y, and r. Now, if x is negative 2 and y is 3, clearly r is not 1. Well, what's the r? Let's see. R squared is equal to, okay, it's negative 2 squared, so negative 2 squared plus 3 squared, and that's, let's see, negative 2 squared is 4, 3 squared is 9, so r squared is 13. And that means r itself, right, is the positive square root of 13. Now remember, r is positive because it's the radius of the circle. So the r right here is the square root of 13. So remember, r does not always have to be 1. There are lots of problems, like this one, for example, where a value of r other than 1 is what you're working with. But it's still true that all of the 6 trig functions can be found simply by taking the ratios of either any of the two values of x, y, and r. So remember that sine of the angle, right? Well, sine of the angle is y divided by r. Always, right? No matter what size r you're working with. So y divided by r is, let's see, 3 over the square root of 13. And I'm going to rationalize the denominator, top and bottom by the square root of 13. And so I end up getting, let's see, it's going to be 3 root 13 over 13. 3 root 13 over 13. Because square root of 13 times square root of 13 is just 13. So that's sine of my angle, right? What about cosine of my angle? Well, cosine is, if you remember, it's x over r. So it's x, which is negative 2, over the square root of 13. Let's write that. negative 2 over the square root of 13. We're going to multiply top and bottom by the square root of 13. And what do I get here? Well, it's going to be negative 2 square root of 13 over 13. That's cosine of my angle. And then let's see, what about tangent? Well, tangent of my angle, that's just y divided by x. So it's 3 divided by negative 2. We write that as negative 3 halves. And then we'll move on to cosecant of our angle. And cosecant, remember, is it's r over y. So r root 13 over y. So it's the square root of 13 over 3. And then how about secant? That's defined to be r over x. So it's the square root of 13 divided by x, which is x is negative 2, right? So we'll put a negative out front and put the 2 in the denominator. And then finally, cotangent of our angle, that is x over y. So it's negative 2 divided by 3. So it's negative 2 over 3. So these would be my answers. I've got my sine right there. I've got my cosine, like so. I've got tangent, and well, I have the other four right here, right? Let's just box those as well. Okay, so what we did is we made use of the fact that x was negative 2, y was 3, and r was the square root of 13. So the point of this example is that you don't necessarily need to know your angle. All you have to know are x, y, and r to find the values of the six trig functions, okay? And so we'll see that as we proceed in trig, being able to evaluate the big six trig functions is a critical skill. Okay, until next time.